Hello friends and welcome back to the channel. As you can see from my desk today will be a review themed CookTech, a brand with which I collaborate since last year, and in today's video we will test and review the latest power bank launched by this brand, the brand new innovative CookTech 15. Power Bank Ultra is a truly revolutionary device, more compact than the previous model, with a charging base of 20,000 mAh compared to the 25 mAh of last year's model. And it was really useful to me because I had forgotten the converter of the German sockets. Since the iFi is in Berlin, I used this power bank to recharge all my cameras, and I was so satisfied that it has become my personal power bank. So I just had the opportunity to test also the new power bank, and I did not miss it. And in this video we will go deeper, both regarding the basic equipment but also doing a little test and time lapse and beyond this power bank. In this video we will analyze these two fantastic chargers. Also, these are just launched, one more massive 100 watt and the other 65 watt. And now, before starting with the theme song, I remind you that if at the end of the video you will be interested in these devices, I left you the direct link to be able to buy them both in the first comment and in the description of this video. Let's start with the unboxing, starting from our CookTech 15 Power Bank Ultra. Inside the package you will also find this beautiful protective case in this soft dark gray fabric, with also the laces to close it. And always inside the package you will also find this very useful double type C charging cable for what? Look at the power supplies we have here, the most powerful one, the 100 watt CookTech gun charger and the lesser 65 watt pound. The box of the 100 watt gun charger is obviously much larger because of the size of the power supply, but also because the inside is included the double type C power cable, which is not present in the 65 watt version. Let's start with the power bank analysis. I tell you right away that the material seems to me really well made, and the dimensions are also really compact. Hold quietly with one hand. As far as I am concerned, the choice of the charging capacity of 20,000 mAh now suits me because it manages to maintain a small size. In fact, the weight is also reduced, which is only 590 grams. Convenient to take with you if in your pocket, handbag, and having the certified airline safe stamp, you can safely take it even on plane trips. A nice advantage for those like me who often travel for work. And the nice thing is that this power bank is equipped with display by one, so quite large, on which you can read both the percentage of remaining battery and all input and output data. Three charging slots, one USB type AE2 USB type CI, two type C slots can be used both to recharge but also to recharge the same power bank because they work both in and out. Instead, the USB type A slot is only used to charge the USB type A port, has a charging power of 18 watts. Compatible with all devices that have a super fast charging, and instead the CDUA has a power of 90 watts, equipped with PD 3.1 protocol, and has universal compatibility with practically all devices equipped with type C, Android, iPhone, MacBook, and any other device that recharges with the port type C state of pass-through technology, that after we will go to test, i.e. mine recharges other devices, he himself can recharge in conto temporanea. In fact, as you can see from the orange screen, we have a total input of 43 watts. It is in fact receiving power from this output power supply, i.e. the output we have 27 watts that it is using to charge both the cell phone and the tablet. Really useful technology. If you happen to use laptops compatible with charging via USB Type-C, you can use this as a battery or as a UPS. Useful, for example, if you are using mini computers. Positive that I use often when I am away to edit. By connecting the power bank to the power supply, you can remove the classic power supply of the mini computer and charge it directly from the power bank. Let's try it. I immediately disconnect the power. As you can see, if I also try to turn it on, it does not turn on. I go to connect the cable type C since this computer is compatible and see what happens. You have seen the computer turned on, so powering the mini computer with the power bank, you will have a sort of up SE. If the power goes out, you won't risk losing all your data, which would normally happen since mini PCs don't have a battery. And I conclude conclude this brief technical analysis, providing you with the last two data. The first that has its maximum output power is 2 at 10 watts, and the other feature worthy of importance is that this power bank also manages to recharge in slow mode. For example, there are devices that by putting them under stress with ultra fast charging can damage or cause deterioration to the batteries. With this power bank, you will not have this problem because by going to set via display by pressing the button, you can activate the slow charging. And as for the characteristics of these two power supplies, I inform you that both have the fast charging PD that makes them compatible with the charging of almost all devices. The commentators are equipped with 3 slots, 2 CE1 USB Type-A, the largest one with a charging power of 100 watts and 65 watts for the smallest one, and thanks to the Gaian system, they prevent overheating during charging. So they are truly tested, certified, and 100% guaranteed directly by the Kaktek brand. And after this brief technical analysis, let's start immediately with the charging test. Let's test the charging with beast mode. Now the power bank is at 0% in total. How? I was saying in the introduction, it has a capacity of 20,000 milliamps. Now I'm curious if it will live up to expectations with a charge in mode in just 45 minutes. I've already set up the clock for the time lapse. This is the camera. Let's insert the 2 super battery chargers of the Kaktek One. And now that we have connected everything, let's start with the test. The beast mode has already been activated and watch the watts as they are growing, and can reach a maximum power of 165 watts, recharging it completely in just 40 minutes. And here it is, power bank recharged to 100%. In just 40 minutes, truly approved the beast mode and above all approved also the 2 chargers. And among other things, I also tell you that to the touch, they have not heated up minimally. So also with regard to safety, I can do nothing but recommend them. And now that we have recharged the power bank, we do a second time lapse going to recharge these 2 ragged phones. Both have 10,000 milliampere batteries now. Simultaneously, while they will be charging via the power bank, we will recharge this super tablet, which has a battery of 20,000 milliampere hours, and we will recharge this with our super transformer. So there will be 3 super recharges that will be recorded by our ISTAT 3 and 60 to make also in this case a beautiful time lapse. Let's start with the first one. Look how the hand is going up now. Let's also proceed with the second one. It has already started to load in this case too, and here you can see all the information for how much. Look at the charging, and despite the double charging, the temperature, even at the stretch, remained really under control. Less than 40 dBA, and the safety protections of Kaktek are truly cutting edge, and you will have maximum safety even if you use them in environments with extreme temperatures. And also the charging of this super rugged tablet is completed, and as you can see, it has a battery of 20,080 milliamps. Also, hearing the transformer with the hand, I can confirm that it has heated up very little. So if there were no temperature problems to recharge a tablet from 20,000 milliamps, now you will certainly not have any problems on any type of device. I hope this review was useful, and especially if you are interested in this Kaktek 15 Power Bank Ultra and the power supplies I left you the direct links to be able to buy them both in the first comment and in the description of this video. As a selling price, it will be approximately sold at 90 €, but it is easy that there will be offers or even discount coupon codes to pay for it even less, perhaps already starting from the next Prime Day offers that will be on Amazon in July. As for the chargers, the small 65 watt one is sold at 29.99, while the more massive 100 watt one is sold at 49.99. Even in these cases, there will certainly be some offers, and of course as soon as these will depart too. See, I will leave it directly both in the first comment and in the description of this video from Lukatek and the arsenal of Kaktek. I would say that's it. I salute you and see you in the next video. Hello!